Democrats powered through cities and suburbs to reclaim the White House, but the party tells further has fell further behind in huge rural swaths of northern battleground states.
President and founder of United Rural Democrats of America, Joe Shepherd, joins us now to discuss how their group is fighting for rural communities for the Democratic Party. Great to see you, Joe.
Hey, good to see you, Joe.
Good morning.
So you just launched, first of all, congratulations, and you should make sure and give people your web address as well. But, you know, there was a lot of discussion after this election about what's gone wrong for Democrats in rural America, a lot of blaming of the squad and such things. But the truth is that Democrats have been losing rural America for a long time now. Under Barack Obama, something like 1,000 state House legislative seats were lost across the country. So this decline has been a long time coming. What do you trace back to be sort of the root of the problem for Democrats in rural areas of the country?
I think it actually also applies to how some Republicans do struggle in urban areas as well. I think that after the 1980s, you saw sort of a nationalization of both political parties. And as a result of that, a lot of these sort of regional flavors of each party slowly petered out. And I think that as the last of these sort of pre-Clinton era rural Democrats die out, the Democrats are just going to struggle in these areas. So I think we need to sort of, you know, tend the flame and bring it back.
So tell me about what exactly your group wants to do, where you see the biggest glaring problems. We've talked, obviously, with a lot of people on the show about where a lot of this comes from. It seems to me, more than anything, cultural bifurcation, especially along the educational and class divide. There's a piece out in the New York Times over the weekend citing exactly this. The most consistent dividing line in America today is whether you have a four-year college degree, and the country just seems to be separating along those lines. How do you want to work to bridge that gap?
Well, I do think that, you know, obviously the United States of America is a vast nation. We have many little intricacies and diversities throughout, you know, every corner of this nation. So I do think there are going to be cultural differences when it comes to social issues. But I think that we can all get behind sort of prosperity. Most people in this country, I've noticed, are pretty apolitical, and they just sort of want what's best for their family and at large for their community. So I think that if the Democrats can sort of push on a message of economic prosperity and results, instead of more controversial issues, they can really make some extreme headway, especially in areas that need it.
Joe, how much receptivity have you found for your project in the Democratic Party proper? Because this caught my eye. J.D. Schulten, candidate, you know, I'm friends with, we've had him on the show, who ran in a really rural district in Iowa where you're going to school. He says that, look, he ran this campaign, ultimately was a successful no, but he improved Democratic performance dramatically in this rural district. He focused on issues of trade, issues of monopoly in particular, ran this sort of populist grassroots campaign on the ground. Nobody from the party has even reached out one time to ask him, what did we do right? What did we do wrong? What are the lessons? What does the data look like, et cetera? So, I mean, does the party even care to try to win back these areas at this point?
I think they do, because I have spoken to some people within the Democratic Party, and I think the answer is more ignorance rather than apathy. I feel like because these kind of rural democratic infrastructures have declined so much in the past quarter century that they don't really know how to reach out because those lines have been so damaged. I think JD was an excellent candidate, and my group intends to support more people like him who are sort of people of their district. I think the Democratic Party proper is excellent at raising funds, at doing those sort of administrative things. But when it comes to candidate selection, I believe that local organizations who actually live in the areas where these candidates run in should have a lot more say in who gets the big checks.
Yeah. And then the real question to me, Joe, is where do they need to move on policy? What do the Democrats have to move on policy if they want to win some rural voters back? Or does policy even matter? Is it just all culture?
I think there is definitely a policy element to it. I think that I was speaking with a woman in Fentress County, Tennessee. So just a little preface. In forming this, I've spoken to over 2,000 people in about 46 states to try and see sort of what the people on the ground feel like. And that is going to be a major component of our organization. Our organizers are going to be also, in addition to political activities, discussing, you know, these kind of kitchen table issues. I think when it comes to policy that if the Democrats talk about issues like rural broadband, where 40% of Americans don't have access to that, or hospital closures due to Medicaid expansion being rejected in states like Tennessee. I know going back to Fentress County, this woman was talking about how last year, before COVID, their rural hospital closed. And, you know, heart attack and stroke deaths have gone up noticeably because now it's an hour ride to the hospital instead of 10, 20 minutes for those people. Mm-hmm. And, you know, my mom's a nurse, and they say there's sort of a golden hour when you have a heart attack or a stroke. And if you can act in that golden hour, then your chances of having less symptoms, less permanent damage, less death is much more likely. So I think that if we can sort of talk about these issues that affect everybody, and I think there are a lot of them that affect everyone regardless of class or section, we can really break through.
Joe, you've taken on a big challenge here. I admire you for it. Where can people learn more about what you're doing?
Absolutely. So our main platform is Twitter, because I believe that, you know, a lot of these local organizations feel absolutely powerless to do anything. So I want the wider world to know about, you know, good local candidates who represent their community's values, you know, local events, or, you know, God forbid, if there's something wrong, then I want people to know about it so things can be done about it. 2020 has been a year of renewed activism. So you can check us out on Twitter at rural_united on Twitter, and theunitedruraldemocrats.org. Our website is currently being rebuilt because we just launched. We're going to be adding our platform soon, but it's all there.
All right, yeah. Joe, thanks so much. Great to have you.
Thanks, Joe.
Perfect. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
All right, Sweden's herd immunity experiment is coming to a close, and lockdowns in California have a business owner calling out that governor. We're going to discuss when Rising continues.